Fans, we are back. We have, you don't like to see this, regardless if it's a member of the NWO or a member of WCW. Buck Bagwell apparently is severely hurt here.
He's conscious, though.
Our trainer is out. Bagwell, Scott Steiner tried to roll Bagwell up on top of his brother, Rick Steiner, and Bagwell was really could only get the arm up for the pin, and the medical attendants are here and right now to check out with Buff Bagwell. And now Scott Norton's helping out. Buff Bagwell, right now they're trying to immobilize him, and we were supposed to go back to the ring for our next match, but obviously we cannot right now until they get the ring cleared. A very unfortunate set of circumstances. We will keep you abreast of the condition of Buff Bagwell as it becomes available to us. It's going to take quite a while, I understand, obviously, quite a while for them to be able to get Buff Bagwell onto that stretcher and get him immobilized. Vincent in there, as you can see. Our trainer is there.
You want me to go down and find out?
Stay with us right now. We need to look, we're going to go back, I understand, and take a look at how this injury occurred, and maybe we can get a little more insight into exactly what is wrong here with Buff Bagwell. To me, we were all screaming, and obviously for good reason, about Scott Steiner hitting his own brother with a chair. But here's what happened just moments ago here live on Thunder. We ready to roll that tape? All right, we'll have that tape in just a second here. Here it is. Up on top. Oh, my goodness. Buff Bagwell's head, as you can see, hit the back of Rick Steiner. And then Scott Steiner nails his brother with a chair. He gets Bagwell's arm over, and that enabled the 1-2-3 count. But
you can see Bagwell's even having a difficult time there extending his arm to make the cover.
Yeah.
We hate to draw conclusions at this time about the severity of an injury like this, but this certainly doesn't look good for Buff Bagwell.
And his head hit the hit Rick Steiner like it. This is, and that's why a lot of times we are in awe and scream and are amazed about the athletes that come out here and perform each and every week, because literally they do put their lives on the line, their careers. And you can see the fans here at ringside.
You want me to see if I can find out anything?
Very concerned. Yeah,
let me just walk down that way.
Rain is going to walk down if you don't mind. And he'll try to get a report on Buff Bagwell.
We're getting some word here now, Tony, passed to us. I guess there's an ambulance that is on its way here to the Carolina Coliseum. They're doing everything they can. Obviously, they don't want to move him. He's been immobilized.
All right, and unfortunately, fans, when there is an injury in the head and neck region, like it's obvious it was from that replay, they will not move him. And so we are going to have to wait on the ambulance to arrive here. And Bobby the Brain Heenan has gone down. And so we're just going to have to wait it out. And we're very sorry about this. You even see members of Raven's flock very concerned. And we're sorry about this. We were supposed to have a Chris Benoit psychosis matchup at this time. But obviously we cannot. And we're going to just have to stay here and bring you this as it comes. Bobby the Brain Heenan is down there, and while Bobby Heenan is down there giving us trying to find out exactly how Bagwell feels, good news is the man's conscious, and as you can see, the fans are literally stunned here.
Yeah, you can see the concern on the face of the fans, the wrestlers, WCW officials. Precautionary measures are being taken. Well, maybe Bobby can get us some word about an early report.
That's our executive producer, Craig Leathers, there talking to Bobby Heenan. You saw David Penzer, and so this is going to take quite a while, and for you fans, I know you're hooked in here to Thunder. You're watching. You're as anxious as we are, and we're just going to have to wait this out. We're sorry, but obviously the condition of our athletes comes first.
This
is
live
television.
Man, guys, I just came from the locker room. Each and every one of the wrestlers, of course, concerned about the condition of Buff Bagwell, as is everybody here in Columbia, South Carolina. But this has really captured the moment, the heart, and certainly the emotion of everybody in this building, including the athletes.
All right, fans, Brain, you've made it here. Lee, if you'll hand him your headset. We're sorry about doing this impromptu, but like you said, Mike, it's live TV. All right, what do you find out, Brain?
I talked to Craig Leathers, our executive producer, and he says it's a cervical injury, and they can't move him now until an ambulance comes. They can't put him on that chair. They're waiting for a gurney to stabilize him. they're just, everyone's in kind of shock down there. We're just going to have to
we don't want to
stay here. There's nothing we can really do. They can't go into the ring until they can move him.
We don't want to speculate on any of his injuries until we find out for sure. All right, we're going to show you what happened once again moments ago. Now, notice Bagwell's head as it hits the side of Rick Steiner as he comes down right there.
Oh.
That's a horrible scene. That is a horrible scene.
There was just nowhere for the head to go at that point. Just looked like it jammed right against the back of Rick Steiner.
All right. We certainly have a lot of issues to deal with and a lot of things to talk about as it relates to our title scene and as it relates to WCW, and we do need to talk about that. But right now, our thoughts are here with Buff Bagwell.
Well, it's an awfully difficult situation at this time, Tony. Just the concern, you can just feel it all throughout the arena. I know Lee Marshall has gone down there to try and get possibly further word.
Brain, sit down here. They're going to come to us. And, okay. Well, there is a lot of concern everywhere. Members of NWO, members of WCW, and certainly with us and fans. This is really, to be very blunt about it, taking the steam out of us here and the condition of Buff Bagwell. Fans, we heard from Hollywood Hogan. And Hollywood Hogan talked about retiring the Macho Man Randy Savage. But, you know, a scene like this that sickens all of us, and I'm not going to speculate on the severity of his injuries right now. You combine that and taking the wind out of our sails with the comments from Hollywood Hogan and Hollywood Hogan talking about how he is now ruling the New World Order. Hollywood Hogan says he's in charge of the NWO, but I think it's very apparent from what happened this weekend, there's a split right down the middle of the NWO.
There's obviously a rift. It appears that there's factions forming at this point within the New World Order. He talked about that celebration earlier and the fact that there wouldn't be any cameras backstage, just not like Hogan. He loves that spotlight. And for there not to be those cameras backstage, I think there's another reason. He also talked about the Savage retirement. I'd like to hear that from Savage himself, though, Tony.
All right, fans, I'm told now we are going to have to take a commercial break. Fans, stay with us. We hope to get the ring cleared and hope that Buff Bagwell is okay. That's all we can tell you. We'll be back live on TBS after this.
See live WCW action in a city near you. Tomorrow night in Asheville, North Carolina at the Asheville Civic Center. Friday night in Florence, South Carolina at the Florence Civic Center. Saturday night in the Independence Arena in Charlotte, North Carolina. And Tuesday night in Salisbury, Maryland at the Wacomico Youth and Civic Center. Don't miss live WCW action coming soon to an arena near you.